ஸ்டார்ட் பண்ணிடலாம்.
All present here. It's my pleasure to extend a cheerful welcome to you all for the webinar on stress management for high performance conducted by Department of Advanced Training and Coaching. So let's begin the webinar by seeking the blessing of the Lord Almighty with a silent prayer. Thank you. May I now invite Dr. C. Arumugam sir, organizing secretary for the webinar, Department of Advanced Training and Coaching, to welcome the gathering.
Very, very good morning to one and all. Really, it gives me immense pleasure to see you all in this, on the screen for this wonderful national webinar on stress management for high performance. In this juncture, I would like to welcome our resource person, the great Virender ji, sports psychologist from Telangana state. On behalf of the university vice chancellor, registrar, department of sports coaching, on behalf of you all, on my own behalf, I extend my warm welcome with folded hands to Virender ji. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
I extend warm welcome to our own faculty members from different departments: psychology, physical education, exercise physiology, yoga, nutrition, statistics, management, and all. And all my beloved students from Department of Sports Coaching, Department of Physical Education, Department of Yoga, Sports Management, the students undergoing distant learning program, gym instructor course students, and other students apart from our own faculty and our university, faculty members from abroad. I seen Anthony C. Varghese have attended from abroad, and a few more others from other universities, nook and corner of the country, are also joining with us to update their knowledge in terms of stress management for the higher level performance. So once again, I welcome you all for this wonderful webinar on stress management being conducted by the Department of Sports Coaching of Tamil Nadu Physical Education Sports University. Once again, I welcome all the dignitaries, all the participants to attend this seminar. Whoever comes, we extend our warm welcome. Once again, I welcome you all. Welcome.
Thank you, sir, for your kind words of welcome. May I now invite Professor Shaheen Ahmed Madam to introduce the resource person.
Good morning. Thank you, Dr. Arumugam, for giving me an opportunity to introduce the speaker. I'm glad to introduce him because he is my colleague belonging to my fraternity. So to the participants, I'm happy to introduce him to the participants. So to start with, actually, the list goes very long. But I'm just putting it in a nutshell. So his appointments, to start with, he has been appointed as a psychologist for sports of authority of Telangana. He has attended national games 2015 at Kerala. Then he has been a TSPSC interview board member as personality assessor in recruiting engineers for irrigation and other government departments since February 2016. He has been in Telangana Police Academy. He has been giving expert inputs in designing the training module syllabus for new recruiting SIs. So his formal education has been PG Diploma in Psychological Counseling from Mumbai, PG Diploma in Counseling and Guidance from Annamalai University. He has done his MSc Psychology from Kakatiya University, Telangana State. His MPhil is from Central University, Hyderabad, Telangana State. He has done his PhD in Physics from Usmania University, Telangana State, and his MSc Physics from Usmania University, Telangana State. So he has a rich experience. He has been serving in different capacities, 10 years as a mental conditioning coach and trainer for sports persons, 14 years of counseling on various issues of adults, anxiety, depression. Then he has been involved in organizations, educational institutions, hospitals, professional learning centers. He has put in 15 years experience working with teenage and adolescent students in building the self-esteem. He has worked on student suicides during the Telangana movement. He has been involved in counseling farmer suicide, self-confidence building sessions in districts. He has been involved in teenage emotion awareness programs since 10 years. So he has also been an invited speaker as lead speaker. His experience includes, he has been in International Conference on Sports and Physical Fitness, New Delhi, India. He has been in International Conference on Sports Management 2017 in Vietnam. In International Conference on Physical Fitness Science 2017, Davao City, Philippines. In International Conference in Physical Education and Gulbarga University 2017. International Conference on Sports Sciences and Physical Education in Usmania University 2017. International Conference in Sports Yoga and Physical Education, Manipal University, Jaipur, Rajasthan 2016. Madam, International Madam. Conference on Madam. Physical Education.
Don't read is enough.
No, sir, it's a pleasure, sir, because we should know, isn't it? So, you know, I'm happy to share all your information to our participants.
Thank you.
So, Sports Sciences, Usmania University, 2016, and he has been in Counseling and Guidance, RAIE, Mysore, Karnataka. Then he has been involved in personality development and training students. About 3 lakh students have been benefited through his personality development program, and parents about 50,000, professionals 30,000, and teachers 20,000. So emotion awareness talk has been given to the teenagers. So Bell RC Puram to Hanamgoda around 15,000 students. He has conducted 2 days workshop on Know Your Student for lecturers. He has been on regular mission for the past 7 years, emotions awareness campaign in and around Hyderabad. Around 1 lakh students have been benefited by this. He has organized workshop and seminars, Know Your Student, 2 days workshop for professors and teachers at Satwata University, Palamuru University. 1 day seminar and youth policy, need of the hour. CVSR Engineering College, Hyderabad. 1 day seminar and Right to Information Act, JNTU. 1 day seminar at Usmania University. His overseas experience has been, he has been a visiting research scientist at Changhua University of Education, Taipei, in the year 2002-2003, he has presented papers on effective counseling methods on NLP to enhance the performance of players, and he has been giving talk on effective counseling methods to diffuse anxiety pressure to give the best performance by the players, Davao City, Philippines. So he has been a consultant for state government organizations, Mari Chennai Reddy Human Resource Center, SICA Training Center for Jail Employees, National Thermal Power Corporation, then Usmania University, Ambedkar Open University, Hyderabad Housing Corporation. So he has been doing social service in number of projects. He has launched a helpline for depressed students, organized number of stress management sessions for rural and urban students of AP and Karnataka states, organized awareness programs against student suicides. Then expertise in handling and techniques used, especially with the athletes, depression, suicidal tendencies, relationship issues, adolescent blues, opposition sex relationship issues, parent-child conflicts, ADHD, CBT, hypnosis, NLP, transaction analysis. So he has been doing number of shows on television. It includes TV9, ETV, TVS, NTV, Doordarshan, Teja, Gemini, Sakshi Studio HMTV. Actually, I'm excluding many few because, you know, we don't have enough time. And also the speaker is also not very, you know, he's very magnanimous in not highlighting his achievements. And he has also been a regular columnist. He has been writing daily and weekly articles for the past 5 years in the following news dailies. Namaste Telangana, Eenadu, Sakshi, Andhra Jyoti, Vartha, Prajakshi. Then he has been involved in a number of magazines also writing articles. Telangana, Psychology Today, Classmate, Udyoga Sopanam, etc. Then he has authored a number of books on personality development, Vijay Padam, Successful Student, How to Crack IITG, Vijay Janaki Dharini, Vijay Me Savantam. So he has been a consultant in educational and other private and public sectors in degree colleges, junior colleges, professional colleges. His statewide promotion includes organized and state level statewide tours associated with government of Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, and is also aimed in improving self-esteem among the rural students and covered all districts, junior and degree colleges. Now his present ongoing projects includes working with teenage and adolescent students for 15 years in building their self-esteem, working on how to connect the multiple intelligence in teaching, improving the students suffering with ADHD, creating awareness among parents, professionals, and teenagers about teenagers' love, helpline for depressed and suicidal tendency students, massive campaign in graduation colleges, teenage temptations for the past 10 years. So we are happy to welcome you and, you know, to be a part of this program. So, you know, you have been doing innumerable human service in various sectors, private, public, and as well as different population, including children, parents, teachers, and other workers. Thank you very much, sir. We are looking forward to hear from you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Shine Madam. You are very, you know, benevolent and kind every time towards me. I really feel it is a privilege, and I feel lucky that I could connect with the very great human beings and the very effective professionals in Tamil Nadu Physical Education Sports University. I really profoundly thank Professor Armugam for inviting me for this talk. And also I thank the Vice Chancellor and Registrar Gopinath, and also all the faculty members who are always ready to shower love on me to invite to their campus. I visited once the campus of Tamil Nadu, and also some of the students came to me as interns for the sports psychology. It's a great bond is being developed between Tamil Nadu University. And whenever I get a call from Tamil University, I feel like, you know, it's my home and I can really deliver, and I'll be very much, get very more excited to present myself. So welcome to this wonderful webinar on stress management of high-performance players. And before I start, I would like to thank my parents for giving this wonderful life. I also thank all my teachers who really add a great amount of validation to my life. Let me thank my family, wife, kids, and friends for the continuous emotional support. And let me also thank thousands of students who really tailor-made me what I am today in front of you. Let me also thank thousands of clients who really came to me and enriched my knowledge and also improvised my attention to design the strategies to help the players as well as the clients. Let me also thank the media for taking my voice nook and corner of this world. And let me also thank the farmers of this land who are continuously, constantly feeding us to survive on this planet. Let me also thank in this crisis time, doctors and research scientists who are continuously working to give their best life for us. And let me also thank the sanitation and the police for making the law and order in this world and the high maintaining the hygiene by the sanitation workers. We salute the COVID warriors and to make us live comfortably during this crisis. So the session topic, I think everybody aware that stress management. So it is a very fantastic, because since from morning to evening, down to dusk, every human being in every aspect of life, they've been experiencing the stress. And in this decade, stress is the only word highly used, highly misused, and also sometimes abused also. Because majority of the kids, majority of the elders, professionals, players, everybody will be talking about the stress, how it is really affected. So we are going with the word anytime, wherever you go, people talk about stress management. So it means what? We are already agreed that stresses exist and stress is there. So we accept the stress. Only thing is we need to learn the skills, how to manage it. So the management for what? management for only to be more productive, more helpful to yourself, helpful to the task with which you are really moving on, conducting yourself into the world. So today we are focusing only on the performance, high performance. At a high performance, how people are really going to manage their stress. That is one. What are the methods? Number two is from where this stress is really popping into their brains. From where the stress is entering. And what exactly people who are in the competitions, we can be a little more focused, we call it as a competitive stress. So we try to understand a few things, though you all are aware, so that we can come into that group. Then we slowly travel into understanding the various aspects, how it influences the player, how our brain responds, why when stress experiences, though they are very, very effective in their play, good at the technique, perfect in the practice, and also they perform very high during the practice matches. But once they enter into the competitive zone, why this stress is making people to paralyze? Why their cognitive abilities are failed to connect with their physiology? These things we try to go little in depth, because I could understand that there are all our professionals are there, students are there, and also the much experienced coaches also there. I think I feel very happy that the coaches can take this and apply into the ground level. I think that will be a great honor for me, I believe. So I just share my PPT so that we can guide ourselves to be more direction. Welcome to all successful sport lovers, students, administrators, coaches, and the Indian Dronacharyas, who are really making all the players to perform at higher national and international platforms. So what is a stress in sports? So we talk, it is a competitive stress. Negative emotional state generated when a player feels unable to respond adequately to competitive performance demands. So whenever any person enter into a competitive performance, so naturally the performance need to be better than his earlier performances. Because it is a competition, you need to perform better than other people who are in the competition. Then only you feel that you are successful in the game. So to get the peak performance, one is stress, second is high performance, at the peak performance. Let us see what kind of mental attitude they need to have. So to become a world-class athlete, it requires, everybody knows, the hard work, great mental power, supreme command, and also the superb performance and positive attitude and very passionate desire to win. And many players are amazing and super high levels of fitness, speed, power, agility. And one major difference between them and a champion is that individual mental attitude. Majority of the players and coaches, if you can look into the international phenomena, people always talk about that. When you reach international level, your physical ability and the technique and also the passion will be the same. All the players who reach international level, but only thing is their mental attitude towards the game, towards the competition. This is only make the difference between a champion and a person who cannot reach the champion platform. So the psychological part, the mental power, the mental strength is really, really going to be going to play a key role in elevating a performer into a champion. So across the world, developed countries realize this, that the mental support, mental conditioning, psychological help, is really very useful. Slowly, the country like India, developing countries, slowly started realizing that, yes, in sports science, apart from your physiotherapist, apart from your nutritionist, apart from your coach and doctor, sports psychologist is also going to add value to the performance of a player. So slowly, the government of India and the respective state governments started working. And also the slowly sports universities are slowly growing up, and the sports psychology profession also slowly emerging. And also within come 10 years, I think that this profession, psychologist, sports psychologist profession is going to become really very, very important. And you have with every performer, there is a team, and in the team, sports psychologists definitely exist. And another important thing is that they need to have the belief, self-belief. So self-belief means what? Having a belief on their technique, having belief on their ability, having belief on the coach, having belief on that he can perform better in every competition. And this belief, we are only able to raise your game to the highest level. When your technique and your belief match together, it gives a resonance, then it shoots up your performance abilities. We are calling them as a, that they are in the flow state. In general term, we say that the player is in the form. We take example of Kohli, Dhoni, Sachin Tendulkar, or recently we talked about the Sindhu, Saina. You know, we'll say that they are in the form. What is it, a form? It means they are in the, they come into the flow state. In the flow state, we can understand that the player who is in that particular game, they totally absorb themselves with respect to the game. Nothing is there in their brain. There is no iota of doubt. They are absolutely connected with the every inch of the game, and they absorb themselves and they try to move as an entity. That state of mind, a person, once you get it, then the peak state of the performance of a player exists, and we'll say that the player can really reach the heights in that particular performance. Any player, any athlete, we've been talking, they all experience this. You take the Michael Phelps, a wonderful boy, is a golden boy in the Olympics. He achieved around 22 gold medals in his performance in swimming. Imagine. It means that once he enters into the swimming pool, he is totally into that. When he is swimming, he'll become part of the water. He'll become part of the air. He loses himself. He just flows into the water. And that state of mind, he doesn't know that where is really competing with others, and he is in the competition, and just he becomes an entity in the form of swimming. So that state of mind, every player want to get it. Every person really wanted to work out so that he can give the peak performance. The ability to connect with the self and the game, then there we say that that performance, a peak performance. Let us see for 2-3 minutes some games. So these are the some of the incidents which happened in the international levels. So I would like to ask the participants, what must be the reason behind? What are the things which is popped up into the players? They know the rules and regulations. They were all trained. But once they enter into the arena of the playing zone, why these players are really hitting somebody, pushing somebody, shouting, and trying to harm others? I request the students or participants, please share in the chat box. Can I know what are the reasons? Yeah, they need to win. Good. Anurekha, I appreciate. I focus. Vishwanathan. Please, let me know that you are really following this. Mental stress towards winning. Exactly. Grace Nagarajan. Nice. I appreciate that they are participating in the chat. Please try to share your opinion. They really add value to our session. So it indicates that you are really seriously involving. Not just on and you do your own work in your house. So any other addition, please? What was the reason? Why the players who are internationally acclaimed, they are entering into the fight with the other persons? Yes, Ayyappan changed the mind. Very good. Only need winner's mindset. AK Navin Kumar expectations. Glory Praveen could not control their emotions. Very good. Anuradha ji stressed by other behavior. Okay. Narendra, inability to maintain the stress. Okay, exactly. Nice participation. I appreciate the participants. They're really, you're all focused. Subhash, Lorimban, fight for the victory. More aggressive. Anil, CN Thakran, his key spirit, feeling towards winning. They practice more to win. They could not digest their failures. Very good. Sunil, feeling towards winning. Yeah, due to family problems. Oh. Sifu, Vedagiri, Shangma Sao, frustration. Very good. So I appreciate the participants. Please be like this so that we can make out this session as a very learning session. Failure to execute our plans and tactics, Krishnan. Very good. Thank you very much for all your nice participation and your opinions on this. Yeah, exactly as you said, we think that there will be definitely... the stress levels are very high and that stress levels are converting into an aggression. You know, there are two types of aggressions, as you know, well, you might have studied in your syllabus. One is the instrumental aggression and hostile aggression. In hostile aggression, what they do is they directly have an intention to harm the player. If you can see that every time they are entering into the direct body-to-body attack, so they want to harm the other. In the whereas instrument, they try to take out the through other model to get the expected results, and they try to harm, and the aggression is being shown in that way. So these two kinds of aggressions are possibly exist in majority of the games only because they experience too much of stress. So the stress can be from the expectation, as some of our participants shared there, that they may think that they are losing the game, they are unable to digest. They prepared one strategy. The strategy might fail because of the other persons have a counter strategy on that particular day, or the people might not be in the zone, might not be in flow state while they are playing. So these are all reasons will definitely push some pressure on that. Some of the players or the team itself is being sponsored by his financial, so that company may look at them, how is performance. Our next competition, the finances may not be given to these people when they lose the game. So these are all things really going to disturb them. But question arises, they're all trained. They may be having experiences, they may be having expectations, but they're all trained. But having so much of training, still, will they behave in this manner? Why their brain chemistry, why their cognition, and the feeling and their behavior, how these three are making a person into their clutches and pushing into a wrong behavior? Let us try to know a little more as you are entering into the more discussion on this. See if you can, I just want to share two or three case studies as we have seen videos, and I just want to share my experience, the people who came to me for a counseling, to guidance and to teach them coping strategies. In the badminton, there is one player. This player, during the tournaments, he used to get automatic thoughts about his poor performance. Fear of losing match and create a lot of pressure on him. And he could not succeed against any player. But during practice, he used to win all the matches. Sometimes he's overpowered the coach. This is the case study one. Case study two, always used to win the first game. Same in the badminton. You always, you know, out of three sets, used to win first set. Then every, spectators, coach, umpire, the opponent, everybody used to feel that, oh, yes, such an attacking game. He's very energetic. Then this game is also, second game is also follows to, and he's going to win. But we really surprisingly, in every match, first game he won once, then later part he'll give out the opponent. The remaining two matches is going to lose to the opponent. Third, in a cricketer, there is an under 19 player. He was a captain to an under 19 team. And basically he was a bowler. But because he has some ACL injury, then he started, coach advised him to take the batting. Even in the batting also, he used to go for as opener, but used to do better. But for the past few days, suddenly get a pop-up message that in his brain that he is going to duck out and he is going to clean bowl. He is not going to take any more, any ball, any of pace. Then within 10 minutes, he used to out. So if you can look into this, any person gets the stress because of the thoughts, because of the automatic thoughts which generates in the body. If a player enter into that court or into the field, these kind of thoughts generates, like, I never compete well with this team. I never did well in this particular city or country. I don't like this gym to do my training. Today the day is not going to well, it seems. But I have to win. But I don't think so. This type of self-talk which pop up in your brain, these will lead to the self-sabotage. And player enter into the game with a tremendous pressure and experiences a great stress on him. So some of the stress factors, not all, some of the prominent stress factors which works on the majority of the player who are at the national, international players. First is the expectation of the peers and expression of the self and feeling that opponent player is very strong or team is very strong and the coach is very strong. They were trained in the highest level of international platforms. Fear of failure. I may lose a game. If I lose a game, what happens? What my family thinks? What my friends thinks? What my coach thinks? And it generates a lot of anxiety. You know pretty well when anxiety generates, arousal comes. If arousal is very high, your performance definitely impairs. Then expectation of the coach, because he's been training since a long time, that he has a lot of hopes on you, that you're going to give the all the knowledge and wisdom and the skill what you learn. You'll apply to be successful in the game and self-belief on the technique. And inadequate preparation, you may generate some self-doubt that I must have prepared some more number of hours. I must have worked on with some other XYZ practice and some of the past experiences. Maybe in the national platforms, maybe international platforms, you might have lost certain games just because of your involvement. That experience also pop up and start working on your head and sponsorships. These all combination can create a regular stress on your head. And you have seen Yarson Dodson, 1900, they have identified the how the arousal and stress will really influence the performance. If the arousal level is very small, it means the stress is very low. Then you get boredom and you are not connected and your performance will be slow. As your anxiety level, arousal level and stress levels are increased, then at some point of time is a very optimal level. It is a bell-shaped curve. At that time, your performance will be very high. This graph is not only applicable to the sports, but it is applicable to in general life also. And then slowly, if you can, the anxiety levels and stress levels are very, very high, then your performance drops down from optimal levels to the lowest level. So the lowest stress and highest stress, both are deterrent for the performance of a player. So you need to know, the coach will understand, will make you realize that at what level of anxiety you can improvise, stress levels you can take so that it can push you and give the best performance. So in order to make players to understand, if an athlete or if a runner or anxiety level, what level you need to rise so that your performance can match with that, can be tested in the laboratory. In a sports psychology laboratory, they take you and put it on their biofeedback machine and create an artificial stress on you. And the sports psychologist will be there and create stress and motivation in you. Then that will really create the optimal level of stress. And then they measure the performance and they tell you, this is your performance levels, which can you are supposed to attain. This stress, you can handle it. And you need to work out, you need to control your emotional anxiety or your arousals to be this level. And then you can do the best performance. In general, majority of the players, they experience these emotions. Anger, despair, excitement, frustration, joy, and this combination of emotion spectra, every player will experience well when they are in the competition, when they are playing. So naturally, you all need to know, and you should experience in the emotional intelligence. You need to train understanding emotions, expressing the emotions, perceiving the emotions of others, and using these emotions. These four branch, if you can, trained by a sports psychologist, and you empower your emotions, and then you can become more effective and they'll be under your control. So we'll try to narrow down and we'll try to talk the impact of expectation and self-belief and performance. These are the two things we try to travel a little more deeper and understand how your brain works. What is the expectation from self? Meeting your expectations for yourself is as simple as believing your ability to rise those expectations. An expectation is a firm belief that something will happen or in the case in future. So what is the expectation from others? Naturally, you have to perform better and you will perform. And what is self-belief in ability? Ability is that which is come with you, that you are by default physiological ability which is there with you, which can take up the task and you give the best performance. And this belief and your performance and ability combined together as a combo and which can really shine as a great player. And the self-belief leads to two types of fears. It is a very typical in sports. What if I make some type of mistakes that impacts the team negatively or makes me look bad? What if we don't accomplish our goal? These two things will also touch the majority of the players. So naturally, we need to know the fear of personal failure can turn into thoughts of self-doubt, such as, I'm not good enough and my teammates and coach think I am no good. I'll never be considered and dependable. Coach is going to pull me out of the game or I'll never reach my goals. And this naturally leads to anxiety. Anxiety is not something different of fear. It's another form of the fear. We call this a evolution of the fear. So fear has direct link to your identifiable object. And anxiety depends on the synergetic effect of one's trait anxiety, perceived environmental threats, and the conscious process. This conscious process will impair your performance because the training before any competitions by the coach is only to connect your physical activity with your subconscious. So when you enter into the zone, you never think and act. Your body and mind both become synchronized, and then you subconsciously you keep on responding to the each and every stimuli given by the opponent. Maybe in the football, maybe in the volleyball, maybe in a cricket, maybe in shuttle, or maybe in table tennis, your whole body has eyes. Your body will perceive the ball when it approaches you, and based on that, you prepare yourself. Your body will prepare with respect to the challenge posed by the ball. So this kind of connectivity, we call them as you have really trained yourself very well. Then once you enter into the fear, then worry starts. Distraction theories propose that worry will indulge a cognitive impair, which shifts the performer from attention from task to task irrelevant thought. You know, this is the major disturbance which causes in our brain. When you enter into the worry, actually you are trained to take the task. But when you get the self-doubt, your brain pushes you from working on the task to a task irrelevant thought. So the processing efficient theory and attentional control theory says that while creating high cognitive demands, anxiety in the form of worry preempts the resource of working memory, and this leading to impaired performance. See how brain works. See, when you are practicing, your brain stores all the techniques, all the skill, and all the strategy when you are entering into the game. Once worry starts, the PET and attentional control theory says that this worry will empty that memory, working memory. The skill what you stored during your competition, during your training, this worry will totally remove that. The skill, the energy, the strategy, the information, the knowledge what you gathered in the form of training from your coach and by yourself, the worry will totally washed off. What happens? It leads to impair your performance. Then you become blank. In such a huge stress, when your working memory, which is carrying all the skills and strategies which you have been building, which you have been storing like a reservoir for the past so many days, it becomes empty. That leads to the impaired performance. Once it is impaired, then it increases the anxiety. Because what happens? Why am I behaving like this? Whether I am going to really do it or not. And this is really have the two purposes. Worry distracts the cognitive process by preempting working memory, which shifts from attention from task to task-relevant thoughts, and it is detrimental to your performance. And worry also serves a motivation function. Worry about performing poorly may lead to the reallocation of additional cognitive resources, and thus the maintenance of the optimal performance when anxious. So these two things will really trying to create more anxiety. And because you know pretty well that when anxiety is very, very high, then automatically your performance becomes very vulnerable and becomes very poor. So anxiety impairs performance efficiency and more than your performance effectiveness. Performance efficiency is nothing but a long processing time and also quality of the processing. And anxiety is a neurobehavioral level. This is really going to affect your performance. When it happens, the expectation from the self. Almost every instant, the list of compromise in the same things, including pressure, fear of failure, injury, being dropped, letting others down, lack of confidence, overconfidence, loss of concentration, overtrying, doubt, worrying, and worrying about the might happen next. And all this is that some technical error, you do it. And this is also because of error in thinking. Then we'll little more think about what happens in the brain when you are experiencing too much of stress. Your mind is filled with random things every day. Scroll through your mind, automatically have a huge impact on how you feel. They create thoughts that spur into feelings and determine you respond to a situation. The brain is a command center of your body that is able to rewire based on how you train. See, you all know this brain has three domains. One is thinking, second is emotion, and third is your intelligence. You know pretty well intelligence is default quality. And you have a lot of information while you're growing, and it influences your thinking. And because of information which you have about a particular system, it influences your thinking that lead to your feeling. And this triad will design how you conduct yourself in the game or in the society. So when really a bad thought enters, it leads to the bad feeling. The bad feeling will influence your behavior. So you need to be very conscious in understanding your emotions. That is the reason we say that every player must be trained on emotional intelligence in understanding their emotions and expressing their emotions, perceiving other emotions and using that emotion which they experience during the competitions. So it can help you strengthen a habit or weaken it, the brain, and it can improve your performance if you dedicate time to connect your neurons together, and it can increase your productivity with the simple brain exercises, and that can lead to your compounding growth. The brain is truly a wonderful organ that can serve you well. It can either aid you or fail you. All depends on how you program it, how you train it, how you condition it. And also, not everything that is programmed in your brain is true or valid. Many a times, maybe a person who is in the higher level, maybe a teenager who is little growing, the messages popped up into the brain. Sometimes they are not really helpful. Sometimes they are very hurting. Sometimes they are sabotaging. So it is our responsibility to understand what are the negative things, what are the positive things. Negative things, how to realize? Realize that what are the negative thoughts which popping up, which disempowering you, which is making you weak, which is feeling you low, which is not encouraging you to move on, which is making you to demotivate, which is making you to feel weak physically and psychologically, which you make you enter into self-blame. Think that they are all negative thoughts, negative feelings, which are not helpful for you. Something which is encouraging you, some thought which is feeling that you are empowered, some thoughts which are making you feel very motivated, active, go-getting, and these things think that they are positive. So whenever you are going into a negative cycle, immediately realize, oh, why am I going to negative cycle? What is the aim of this negative feeling? Why am I in the pain for so long? Once you enter into self-talk, it changes the perception of the brain, and immediately you will take action to push yourself into the positive side. So because of these, we'll get the some doubts of players. That is, self-doubt, self-inflicted errors, we'll do it. And already we have discussed earlier this. Now we should understand what is peak performance. We discussed about the stress, from where it is coming, how it influences your brain, how is thought process is disempowering your technique. When you experience the stress, it leading to anxiety and worry. The worry is preempting all the wisdom and skill and energy which is stored in your brain, in working memory. They're all totally emptied, and it is pushing into a task relevant thoughts. That can be when you are in the game, when you are in the zone, task is to execute, task is to apply all the skill, task is to compete, task is to use all the skill and move on and be successful in the game. What is a task irrelevant? Task irrelevant is that when I'm playing, if stop, keep thinking about the what coach thinks, what the spectators think, what my parents thinks, what my friends thinks, what sponsors thinks. These are all task relevant thing for a player when he's in the competition, when he's in the action, when he's in the zone. So the shifting from task oriented to task irrelevant is itself, we call that it is a stress. It can be of in any form. But the brain experiences this which can make you move away from the success, winning over the game. I just given a picture of Usain Bolt, a peak performance. You know pretty well Usain Bolt from Jamaica. If you can see his videos and how he's successful, he is continuously keep on working hard to keep up his success and continue for more number of times. And any successful player to give the best performance, this is the 10 points you can keep in your mind. Performing from one highest intention. See, you need to have, to be very successful, first you need to have a highest intention to make these things better. See, this for this webinar, have been working for the past 5-6 days. Though I presented this last week, though I presented the similar kind of presentations for the Sports Authority of India for all the Indian coaches working in the SAI. And earlier in many webinars I spoke. But, you know, when I started this, I once again had the highest intention that I need to give my best. So I started working on various information which is available in the textbooks, started preparing the notes, consolidating them, and then preparing the PPT and giving some images and also making things very clear to present it. These are all things only comes out for me because I have a just intention to give my best. Of course, I work hard. And any player to be national, international level, you need to be give the best performance. For that, you need to work hard. The research result says any person want to excel international level, they have to work at least 10,000 hours. This is the calculated, researched, proven working hours for any person to excel in any task. And the goals need to be very clear. And you need to know what you are inner knowing. And also, you need to have self-esteem and self-confidence that whatever the goal I set, whatever the work I'm doing it, it is going to improve my performance inside. I'm going to give the best. I'm dealing with a setback. Of course, in some times, I'm not able to really work, give my best. But once again, identify that loopholes and start working on that. And working on to overcome the anxiety and the self-talk and the communication. And preparing, of course, mentally good and managing the flow state. So these 10 things are absolutely applicable for any player who really want to give the peak performance. Then once he gives the peak performance, there is a success cycle. In the peak performance, whenever you give, immediately you start talking about your positive self-talk. Like, you know, I'll be able to do it. I'm going to do it. My shot was really good. Then I can win over this game. This is a positive talk you talk. The skill what I learned, I'm going to execute this. I'm just connecting all the basics what I learned to the core in this game. Then this will improve your self-confidence. Then you generate a positive belief. Then you feel very comfortable. Then your concentration improves. Then whatever you think, you execute effectively. Then that lead to the peak performance once again. So we need to try all our level best to be in this success cycle. If not, you enter into a failure cycle. For example, you lost one failure. Then immediately what happens? You enter into the negative self-talk. Oh, always it happens for me like this. I've been thinking the same thing. I'm feeling the same thing. I'm not going to make it. I think I need to check my ability. I think I'm not a matter of material for national, international games. See, increase your self-doubt. With that, what happens? You diminish your confidence. If any match is there going to come for the next month in international level, immediately say, no, I don't think I can play. Then you get a negative belief and also negative expectations. And once you get a negative expectation, it increases the anxiety. Once you increase the anxiety, it disturbs your concentration. Once your concentration is gone, when you are playing in the game, immediately your muscles become very tense and you don't execute anything to accuracy. Then that leads to the failure. see, this is how the failure cycle starts working with the players who could not do very well in the game. So sports psychologists will enter. Once you enter into the failure, they teach you, don't enter into a negative self-talk. This is only a feeling. Negative self-talk is only you are getting feeling that you cannot do better, you can't perform. But in the practices, in the past, you won so many matches. How you do it? You did it because you have that ability. You have that skill. So focus on from negative self-talk to shift on to the fact that you're trained. You're trained to experience the crisis. You're trained to experience the very good shots. You're trained to understand the game and to give the best performance to compete any international player. Then the different cycle starts, and once again it pushes into the success cycle. It enters the positive self-talk and then increases self-confidence. Then it starts with positive beliefs. Then it uses the mental and physical relaxation and improves the concentration. Then you execute smoothly. Then you enter into the peak performance. Then what support you are really going to give? Once you get a failure or you get a peak performance, how to be in the cycle of peak performance? For that, whenever you experience the stress, you are also need to a training, and third methods are going to come out to give the best performance is that the first two regular mental practice before entering into the game, you need to set a goal, practice visualization, self-talk, focus on positive, build in relaxation time, find right tension level, visualize proper techniques, imagine coping with the extreme, see yourself winning, and maintain cool under pressure. These are all things need to be done before entering into the high performance platforms. You know pretty well, majority of the world likes Pete Sampras in tennis. He always has anger bouts, temper tantrums, and he always used to talk to himself that he claimed that I need to get out of this mindset. Whenever you get anger, immediately talk to himself, no, I should come out of this mindset because this is not going to be helpful for me. Let me come out of this. I need to let go of that last point or mistake and stay focused on the present. Last time, because of anger, he might committed a mistake because he entered into the aggression. Whenever you get this kind of thought that, it seems I am not good, better than the other person, immediately it gets the anxiety that also pushes you to anger. Then you used to short the ball, then it used to land up in a mistake. Then he used to realize, I'm going into the anger boat. No, it's not helpful. I should come out of this. Let the last mistake is a mistake. Let it go. Now I need to focus on the present. So I need to stay focused on the present and prepare for the next point. He said in many interviews that he used to indulge in self-talk to empower himself. So self-talk and self-affirmations become a great emotional strength. Then they enhance self-esteem and self-worth. It works a great advantage when the self-improvement leads to a terrific peak performance. Use positive self-talk and visualization. Feed the wolf of courage. It is natural to feel anxiety under pressure. Many athletes try to prepare. The pressure is not there and doesn't exist in the effort to simply ignore the anxiety completely. For most, however, this is not effective technique. The pressure is real and will not disappear. Sometimes people will say that just ignore the anxiety. No, you can ignore the feeling of anxiety, but still body experience it because it is there in your subconscious. It is directly connected to your physiology. So instead of that ignoring, enter into indulge in a self-talk. That what just now I given the model of Sampras. So take the suggestions from the Pete Sampras. What did he talk to himself? So based on your ability, based on your anxiety levels, based on the thought which is popping up in your brain, which is making you totally dysfunctional, pulling out of your peak performance, then talk to yourself which can empower you. Talk to yourself which can make you believe that you are practiced and trained to compete this match, compete with this game and tournaments. Then you definitely overcome from this, and this positive affirmation can make you become very effective. And common affirmations generally many of the coaches sometimes teach their players is, I can do this, I work hard, I'm ready, I'm stronger, I'm faster, I'm better than my opponent. Now I know I can win, I'm going to win, now I am ready. And the chief coach, Gopi Chand and Sindhu, after winning over their Olympic medal, they, in an interview, they said that how the question was, how pressure is going to be managed? What Gopi Chand and Sindhu was agreed, and Srikanth also shared, Kidambi Srikanth also shared the same thing, that avoiding all kinds of external impressions, a mobile, TV, paper, interaction with anybody. Sometimes people are very good. People are always wish us to compete. But if you start interacting with the people, one person may come and say that, you know, we prayed for you. We are ready to do it. We are ready to make you win. This kind of expectation also may create extra pressure, become conscious that so many people around us are expecting to win. Let me win. These external wish may hinder the cognitive skill of a person. It may create a gap between the flow state because of the expectations. That is the reason Gopi Chand always says that, you know, before pushing them into the higher level competitions, they are totally isolated and not to talk to any external person other than the team and other than this group. This is one way of dealing. So another most important, I would like to say that in the visualization process, there is a one technique in the counseling process. We say that neuro-linguistic program, NLP, is one of the most powerful tool what we generally use in the process of the mental conditioning, that we empower their thoughts. We try to make them understand how brain functions. And also whenever they lose a game, we help them to make to come out of the glitches before going to the zone. Once they enter into the zone, whatever the skills, whatever the support system we are given outside, they need to carry into the competitions and make themselves to be very effective. So I'll stop here. I thank one and all for making this game very successful. I think it's a time to ask for a doubt, sir.
Participant can post your questions in the chat box.
Or possibly you can give one chance for them to open, unmute, and they can talk to me.
Okay, sir.
That is also helpful. Yes, sir. Uma, here I can. Sir, if they raise their hand, we can unmute them, sir.
So I have just opened up the participants to unmute themselves for asking questions, sir. Participants, if you want to ask questions, you can unmute yourself and you can ask.
Yeah, thank you, Manoj. Thank you, Manoj.
Yeah, Manoj, I think somebody wants to ask a question. Krishnavini, I think.
Anyone can unmute, ma'am.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
Yes,
you can ask.
You are ready.
Unmute karke baat karo.
Madam, it is there. Failure. She was asking about the failure to execute our plan and the
time.
Sir, there are Anoj, two questions in chat box, sir.
Anoj, can you unmute Krishnaveni?
Yes, sir. Yes, ma'am.
No, again she has muted.
So Virendra sir, you are muted, sir. Please unmute yourself, sir. Virendra sir, you are muted, sir.
Yes. There is a question from Glory Praveen. Like self-talk, how imagery, visualizing technique can help athlete to reach optimal performance? It's a good question. See, self-talk is you are making you to suggesting, auto-suggestion, giving to others, auto-suggestion is that to be in the present situation, don't get carried away with the wrong pop-up message created by your thought. Because every day, every human being experiences more than 40,000 new thoughts create in your brain. So when you, in this flood of thoughts, if you give a suggestion, the brain picks up that suggestion and try to fit into that. This is one method of self-talk. Second is imagery. Imagery is nothing but you are trying to visualize that the particular situation. But NLP is higher level of this. It means you are creating a situation which is not in real, but in your brain, making all the neurons to believe, the software of your brain and body believes that you can create that. You are creating a benchmark in your brain and you are creating a situation where you experience it. Though it is not real, but your brain experiences real because brain doesn't know whether it is a real or a created once it happens in your brain neurons. That is the difference. The NLP has become very successful because you are creating a situation which is does not exist in the game, in the reality, but the brain can believe that it is a real. Brain doesn't know if it is a real or if it is a creating one. Once it is able to visualize by the brain, it thinks that all the neurons that it is real itself. Then the physiology, which is the subconscious is connected to this, will experience the reality and you are training yourself to that particular situation and that is empowering yourself and the benchmark is created and then you will be able to make yourself to be effective. This is how your visualization helps you to become effective. See, there's a research has been done. They have taken two groups. One group is playing a piano of five people. Second group, they are not playing physically piano, but they were trained to visualize that they are playing piano. After training them for 10 days on a particular note, then there is a competition between a physical piano trained people and the persons who are only trained psychologically. Visualization is being done. With little 1 hour, 2 hours of exposure to that piano before entering the competition, almost they have done same. There are a lot of experiments, experiences and experiments are there. Then only the visualization has become very popular in the world. You take any peak performer. It can be a Michael Phelps. It can be a Roger Wood. It can be a Federer. It can be Usain Bolt. Everybody before going into a competition, they practice this relation that they are giving the best performance without any emissions, without any limitations, without any fears. They visualize that they are going to perform. So before going to the competition, they create this picture. 10,000 crores of neurons are going to install the best version of you. And that will influence the total physiology and it is going to happen in the ground. There's a reason we can say that everything in the world happens two times. First in the mind, second in the reality. A Taj Mahal is such a beautiful monument is being created on the ground, but first where it was created, it is created in the brain. Based on this only, it is created on the earth. Similarly, if you really want to give the best performance outside as a player, create that best person of a performer by yourself in your brain, the same thing is going to be repeated in the ground. Hope I got the answer.
Thank you, sir. Sir, I am Anureka.
Tell me, Anureka.
Can I ask a question? Sir, my sister's daughter, she is 15 years old, sir. She is always using mobile phone without studying. Because of we are matured people, because of our age, we can avoid cell phones, whatever we don't want. But because of she is a teenage girl, she is not able to understand the cell phone occupies her timing, sir. How to change her, sir?
See, first of all, we should raise a question. Why the teenager girl is attracted to the cell phone? Because there is no an activity which can bring you her the pleasure. So we need to connect her. We need to expose to her certain activities where she can also get the pleasure. So parents need to learn some methods where they can engage the child so that she can develop the interest in other activities also, which can also give the pleasure other than the cell phone. This is one method. Second method is talk to the girl that how much time really you want to spend time with the mobile and design and what purpose you are using the mobile. That is the second. Third is that let the whole family stop using the mobile.
Okay, sir. Okay,
these are the
okay.
three strategies you can apply.
That same idea, third idea, I am always giving to them.
Yeah.
Stop using the mobile. Okay.
But it is thank difficult for the elders to use. People say that teenage people don't use, but nowadays elders are not ready to lose their phones.
I can, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Sir, one Dr. Thirumalai Kumar is waiting.
Yeah.
Sir, good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon.
Sir, my doubt is on the high performance and doping.
Yeah.
This go in hand and hand. Okay.
Yes.
What is the role of psychologists to prevent this the doping amounts in the high performance?
Yeah, you raised a very interesting and very useful question, Thirumalai, sir.
Yes, sir.
See, when a sports person is being doped without awareness is one, or without consent. Number three, with the consent of the coach. As a sports psychologist, it is your responsibility to give the awareness that doping may increase your performance, but your life is a threat. You are, after performance, your life is going to become miserable. You can bring out so many case studies after doping, what happens to the high-level performer athletes when they start doping. Doping is going to disturb and damage your all internal organs. What you do with this performance? When your health is not good, when you don't get sleep, when your digestion is totally down, you don't really get proper breath. What you do, all these things. So this kind of awareness you need to give for the player not to enter into the doping mechanism. Then that will be, I think, helpful for the player.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Thank you, Uthimal, for a nice question.
Thank you. One Krishnavani Sridhar is there. She has posted one question.
Yeah.
Could you please unmute and ask Krishnavani Sridhar?
Can you ask Krishnavani?
Hello.
Yeah.
Sir, my name is Rajalakshmi.
Yeah.
See, in our day-to-day life, we have the fear of, whether I will be successful. Mm. Those sort of thoughts, negative thoughts are more when compared to positive thoughts. And how yes. to come out of those thoughts, sir?
Yeah, first of all, getting self-doubt is very common these days, because when you get self-doubt, first of all, we need to check whether our goal is unrealistic or realistic. Then how to check whether goal is realistic or unrealistic? Better take a professional help. Go to people like me and put your goal in front of them and check. The professional will assess your personality and see the your personality traits and check your skills. And also we'll check the your motivation levels and also check your effort levels. And also you'll check the knowledge level. So by making all these things, where exactly the problem which is popping up, then it'll make you realize and understand, start working on that area. Then once you start working at that area, you feel empowered from inside and you start feeling that you're growing inside, then automatically your self-doubt disappears and you'll start working and start giving your performance.
Okay, sir. Sir, if I have to contact you regarding this, and how it is, sir? How?
Yeah, you can talk to me on my mobile. My number, you can note down 944-00. 3721 or you can Google it. My number is available on all in the YouTube site or in the Google also. You will get the my number, my website and all things.
Okay, thank you so much, sir. Thank you.
I thank Mr.
Anthony
Varghese for being on the
line. One moment. Due to some technical issue, I think Krishnaveni is not able to unmute her. So in her absence, I am asking this.
Yeah, please.
Just put forth her questions. In absence of the coach or mentor at the moment of playing in the court, how to train player to come out of morbid thoughts on her own quickly?
Okay. See, that's what, you know, before entering into any competition, first of all, we all need to make the players to realize that these, we have to take the case studies. In the realistic case studies, recent past, which player lost, and let them go and see the interviews in the YouTube, what fears they generate and what fears that fellow is experiencing, let them make a note of it. Then the coach or sports psychologist can sit with them, talk on the fears and help them to empower them. Then with this empowering methods and techniques, then definitely they go onto the competitions. And they, whatever the skills we trained outside and before the game, they are really going to execute them.
Thank you, sir.
Madhuri, you can tell me.
Madhuri also.
Ah. Hello, sir. Oh, Dr. Madhuri is there. Oh, hi, Madhuri.
Yes. Hello, sir.
Hi, how are you?
Yeah, I'm very good and wonderful lecture, sir. Very nice to hear everything.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, a few points are added in my knowledge through this lecture. Sir, I was having one question which is very common with all teams.
Please.
When the equal teams are coming for competition and the match, they always have a opponent phobia.
Yes, yes.
And yeah, and because of opponent phobia or the particular team player phobia, somewhere they are very much conscious when they are playing. Means they are not very confident. They are taking care of their all actions.
Yes.
So how we can make them comfortable?
This is really an excellent question you raised, Dr. Madhuri. I appreciate for the question.
Thank you, sir.
Going to benefit all the participants. See, when the players are same, when they feel that the players are in the same level.
Yeah.
See, what I suggest the players is, see how you are measuring that you are same. One is in terms of winning or in terms of the skill or in terms of the knowledge or the training you have acquired. And who is actually a person in the, if it is a team, who is leading the game? So these are the things, first of all, we need to give awareness to each and every player. So don't, first is perceive that what are the strengths of the other team. And also let them perceive that what are their strengths in the team. Then what are the methods we can adopt so that we can enhance from the past status to the bigger status right now. Are we executing them or not? Where exactly we felt we are failure or we are inferior to the other players? So to improvise our status inside, what are the practices we need to do? So we have to write down the at least 10 to 50 questions about each player. We need to raise a question with the same skill, with the same training, with the same perception. Do you think that are you going to win over the other team? Immediately say that no. Then tell me what are the things we need to practice so that we can win over the team or so that you can make yourself to be that you are confident about winning over the team so that you feel that you are bigger than the last time, you better than the last time. Then they start writing, I need to improve my speed, I need to improve my agility, I need to improve my patience, I need to improve my emotions, I need to improve technique, I need to know how I need to be very cautious. All these things they're going to write. Then you need to work out one by one on each player.
Okay, then, so thank you.
You need to, it's like a working on the team. First, you need to talk to each and everybody, come out with this, then discuss in the team and start working with them. And definitely, once they start believing that they are become better than the last time status of their own self, then definitely they start working with more confidence and they face the opponent team.
Okay, thank you. Actually, mostly this kind of thing is seen in the boys' match when the very cut-to-cut team is there.
Yes.
And means alternatively, they dominates the winning.
Yes.
So in that case, it is like somebody will definitely lose. So, you know, yes, they struggle a lot and somewhere they lose sequentially 4 to 5 points.
Yes,
and then
yes,
again, they start recovering.
Yes.
So this kind of situation yes, yes, is very challenging yes, for coaches also.
Yes, exactly. Majority of the teams who lose the game, they lose the game before entering into the game.
Yeah, okay.
in their brains, they lose the game.
Yeah.
See, I'll tell you one historical story. See, I think you know in the history, Napoleon Bonaparte. He was a great ruler, and also he was a great warrior, and also he has a great wish that he must conquer the world.
Yeah.
In that process, he started moving on all his forces and army to conquer the world. And while he started his journey, he entered into the Alps Mountains. Alps Mountains are so huge, and they are unable to see the peak also.
Mm.
Then he wished that there will be other countries after passing on over the Alps Mountains. Then we should also win those people. Then this Napoleon started, climbing the mountains. Whole 10-15,000 army started climbing, and then they could overcome from the peak position and enter into the other country. And this message reached to the kings of the nearby dynasty. Then all kings are very surprised. How come a person really come from other part of the Alps? We are not dare enough to see that whether people exist there or not. They immediately fearful that, he might be very powerful. So we are not going to win with him. So immediately they went and they said that we are surrendered to you.
Oh.
Then the minister of Napoleon, he went to the Napoleon and asked, "Dear sir, how do you know that these people are very weak? When you come out of the Alps mountain and they are going to come and surrender to you and you will win over?" Napoleon told, "Who knows? I also don't know. I only know that if it is a mountain, there should be some peak."
Right.
That's all. So I started climbing it. So the trust in him which made him to be conquer the world, not because of the army.
Right.
So every player, if you can make him believe that he is good at skill, good at practice, right, and good at knowledge, then once he start believing himself that he really is become very effective, then automatically whole team becomes as a synchrony. Then it gives a great amount of the resonance, and as a collective effort, then definitely any team can be ruled out.
Right, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Dr. Ramesh from Anna University.
Yes, sir.
Sir, any method is there to enhance performance for mentally disordered players?
See, this I didn't understand. What is this mentally disordered players? If they're mentally disordered players, they really cannot fit for the matches.
Okay. Sir, hello, sir. I'm Narendran, sir.
Yeah.
Hello, sir.
Yes, you are audible.
How to maintain the stress level for the beginners, sir? If they fail for the first competitions, how to become for the second competition, sir?
Okay. See, failure, we should, as a team, first of all, what you need to do is, just now I given suggestion to Dr. Madhuri also. What you need is, whenever a team fails in one competition, first of all, we should talk to each and every player independently, ask them, what are your strengths in this game? What is the best part of it? Every end of every game, you need to ask them 3W principle 2 times. What went well? WWW. Second is, what went wrong? WWW. End of each competition, you should talk to each and every student, ask them to write down what is went well in this game with respect to you, and what went wrong with respect to you. They definitely narrate, they write down. Then you should tell them. So if you think that this what went wrong is going to be changed, we are going to win. He said, yes. Then train on that.
Yes, sir.
As a coach, you should not feel disturbed, or you should not feel inferior. I did not train well. It's not that. See, the first competition is not the end of the life. You know, we are progressing. We need to move on. So let them not, you should not give any time that it is a must and you should win. It is not. You have trained them on a particular skill. Ask them to execute the same skill in the match. Whether you win or lose, that's secondary. All peak performers, they never focus on winning or losing. They focus on connecting with the skills what they learn to give their peak performance. Once they connect, resilience comes out and they give the best performance. Then automatically they win over that.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Right.
There is a question in YouTube chat box, sir.
Okay.
From Kripa Mukund.
Mm.
What is fear? How to conquer it? Mm. My daughter is 13 years old and she is into badminton.
Mm.
How she can overcome fear?
Mm.
This is what the question is.
Yeah. First is, don't put, as a parent, measure to the parents in India, when they send into the any coaching, the starting day itself, they try to tell that, you know, you should win over every match. It is not possible. Don't, till age of 16 or 17, don't talk about the competition. Don't talk about the winning. Don't talk about the losing, everything. You are in the process of the learning. So learn. If any basics are being taught in the coaching field, learn them and execute as it is. Winning or losing, secondary. So this is the one way you can make her to come out of the fear. That is first one. Second is that don't put more expectation on her. Don't measure the parents in India what they do when they are sending their child to any particular game. Parents will be accompany them and they always keep telling that I'm investing time, investing money, investing career, investing everything for you. So you need to win over. So these things create a huge expectation and the tender minds cannot bear it. So every time they enter into the match, these things will keep on repeating in their brain. And then immediately they get fear that I am not going to win. I'm going to lose. I cannot continue this. I can't go and practice every day. And then slowly demotivation starts. So better is, if you give an opportunity for your child to become a player, allow them to play. Let her be very natural. Let her be ignite herself that she enjoys the game. This is the first way to make her free from all the expectations in the first term of preparation. Second term is, if she is experiencing anxiety or fear, you should make it very clear. You know, fear is nothing but, it is, if you can explain that word, each and every letter, F-E-A-R, F means, it is a fiction, experiencing as a reality. So some fiction is created in the brain. When fiction comes, they think that it is real. So we must create an awareness that it is only a fiction. It is not real. And what is real? Real is that you are training. Real is that you are a technique. Real is that you are work hard. Real is that you are executing the skill in the ground or in the field, on the net. These are the facts. Focus on these facts, not on the fiction which get into the brain. Then automatically they come out of the fear. Okay, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. This is Professor Grace Helena. Congratulations for your wonderful presentation, Virendra, sir.
Thank you very much, Grace.
And congratulations to Dr. Armugam and Shaheen and other members for arranging a wonderful person for this webinar. And thank you very much, sir. It was indeed a great session today we had. And in spite of all these things we have, why we could not bring medals to country in Olympics, especially. Yes, see, this is a big debate, and we need to sit hours together and analyze all these things. But the nutshell, if you could explain, the people will understand why.
I'll tell you one thing. Till now, India having 130 crores. And there is around 70 crore people are as students. Our culture is not to play. Our culture is not to be healthy. Our culture is not to, you know, make our life better by in the sports and keeping ourselves healthy. Our culture is that you should get marks by hook or crook. You should get the good job or hook or crook. So these are our value system. So if we can shift the students from hypocrisy to reality, if you can make the students to understand what is reality honestly, and if you make the students to accept whatever you are, then these things will going to disappear and we are really take up what is useful, what is healthier, what is progressing things, and we adopt the physical education and the sports into our life, and then we'll prosper. Till that point, it is very difficult. So there are two group of persons need to be give awareness on this. One is parents. Second is teachers. This world still, I strongly believe, this world can be changed to a progressive and prosperous and healthy world, healthy society, only with the teachers. Teacher community, as long as they take it that this is a pride to change, give and inspire the students to be very effective, accepting the reality honestly. No one can change this world. So teachers, if you can take out this forward, I think, as you said, we can definitely win over more medals in coming Olympics.
Thank you, sir. That was a great answer from your side. And I hope that everyone understood what it is.
Yes.
And thank you once again.
Yeah, thank you.
Virendra sir.
Yeah.
There's two things I want to acknowledge.
Yeah.
One is, in my coaching career.
Yes.
I have said about the case two.
Yeah.
Where the, after winning the first set, the team tend to lose. It is 1000% correct as far as my experience is concerned.
Yes, sir.
During my coaching period, I lost two, three matches based upon this.
Okay.
And somehow, without knowing the fact, I thought myself that the reason could be maybe as these factors, psychological factors.
Yes.
So I used to teach them, after first match or second match, you should be more confident on, you take it granted, this is first match.
Yes.
Previous match, don't take it off previous matches.
Yes, yes.
That is why I managed, and so many matches I won after losing two sets.
Excellent.
There are lots of examples.
Oh, yes, sir. Yes,
that
sir.
Is the reason. It is true as far as the case two is concerned.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. See, the players who came to me, because when they enter into the second match, immediately for various reasons, their brain used to pop up that now you are the best and you are going to win.
Yes.
Second is that they start feel that they have some sentiments will work out on them.
Right.
And then they see that the first is only mine and second, third, anyhow, it is going to other person.
Correct.
So I cannot make it. Mm-hmm. Third pressure is that once they enter into the second match, people start expecting more. And this match also, I should win over. You know, they become very conscious about their play.
Yes, sir.
Once a player becomes very conscious about what they play, their cognitive abilities slowly start shifting from task-oriented to task-relevant things. Once the task irrelevant things start popping up into your brain, their ability is slowly diminished and the shots, what they wanted to do it, they slowly, they are going to lose the game. So as I said that we need to train them to enjoy the game. You become part of the game. Whether win or lose is a secondary. You definitely win over it. But only thing is you need to be conscious about how best effectively you are playing, the skills, what you have learned, how accurately you are able to execute in the game. Whether it is two games, it is 3 games, it is 10 games, 100 games in a series of 10 days or 15 days, but you are need to be effectively, you are trained for it. You are meant for it. That learning and executing, learning and executing. That's only you just do it. You fail or pass secondary. So this requires a great training is being done with the sports team. Maybe a coach and the parent and the therapist and also a psychologist can help this person to become very effective.
Fantastic, sir.
Yeah.
Second one is that,
yeah,
as you have mentioned about the anxiety level.
Yes.
So during the matches, the players may tend to lose his confidence level.
Yes.
Because of maybe stress or anxiety. So I ask them to recollect their own past performance during the previous years or previous time. His performance must be the best.
Yes.
So I ask them to recollect your past experience, past performance,
correct,
then you can able to win the match. Like exactly. That, so many matches I won.
Very good.
So
sir.
This
very
is
good.
One example.
Yes, yes. I say for the, we train players, we have tools, some psychological exercises are there in NLP, neuro-linguistic programming. We train them with visualization. We have some methods, anchoring methods are there, the balloon exercises are there. First and best picture exercises are there, and center of excellence exercises are there. These are exercises are meant for a particular issue. So before any player go to higher level performances, we train them and ask them to apply. when it is required. Then automatically they apply it and they overcome from that negative influence and they become very positive and effective and they perform in the team.
Thank you very much, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, only one thing.
Sir.
You basically, your physics based yes. Man.
Yes. Yes, sir.
How it tracks to psychology. very, I could not.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Actually,
unimaginable. So physics is one corner and psychology is a different corner.
Yes,
how
yes,
it matches.
Yes, you know, physics or psychology, both are helping you to enter into the living and non-living things to study the dynamics of that. And majority of the physics principles are applicable in psychology.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, yeah. And that really made me to become very effective in understanding the things and started learning out of my absolute interest. Then I did courses and then started working on the sports psychology.
Fantastic, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir. So I appreciate. Shall I stop, sir?
Yes, please, sir. Uma? Yeah. Uma?
Sir, yes, sir.
Start, Manish. Now it is time to honor the guest on behalf of the University Vice Chancellor, Registrar, Department of Sports Coaching. On behalf of all the participants, we appreciate wonderful lecture on stress management, Dr. Psychologist Virender Ji. So on behalf of you all, we appreciate and a small moment of appreciation certificate. We are very, very happy to give to Virender Ji. Sir, please.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. Thank you for the certificate also. I appreciate your spirit of inviting me to update the skills of all the participants. Hope this session is very helpful for all of you.
Yes. Uma, what are thanks for Lama?
Yes, sir.
So we are coming to the end of this wonderful session. What of thanks? I am Arumugam. I would like to express my sincere gratitude to our Vice Chancellor and Registrar for having granted me permission to conduct this national webinar on stress management and high performance. I would like to express my heartfelt thanks to Virender Ji, though he has got a lot of, busy schedule. Working all the ways for the development of human beings to the better level, taking the individual from the stress. So he's taking a maximum effort to prepare all the things and shared a lot of issues. Actually, the session was 50-50, only half of the 60 minutes talk means 60 minutes interaction. It was very, very effective and all were satisfied with your performance, sir. And we have the university because lots of input we received from you, sir, starting from what you call as the Michael Phelps, the status and state of mind mentioned about that. Then the case study 1 and 2, then self-talk and the worries, how it interacts, how it affects the performance. And so many, the top form, that there are 10 facts, 10 points to be keep in mind for the reaching the top level performance. So many things. So everything was very new and wonderful for the participants on behalf of university, on behalf of all the participants. Lastly, on my own behalf, I extend my sincere gratitude and heartfelt thanks to you for this wonderful session with my folded hands, sir.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sain, Dr. Arumugam.
On behalf of all the participants, we pray God to shower his blessing to Virender Ji so that you can take so many stress of the people all over the country. You can take this stress and the lifespan can be extended. So for which we all pray God to shower his blessings for long life on behalf of all the participants on the university behalf. Once again, on behalf of the this webinar committee, we once again extend my warm thanks to you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your love.
I thank all the participants for their wonderful interaction. And so it was 126. It was keep on say all the participants were there.
Yes.
Beginning to end, they were there.
Yes.
We appreciate and we express our thanks to all the participants, especially Madhuri and Verghese from other faculty members from other state also. And I extend my sincere thanks to all the participants. And the last but not least, I express my sincere thanks to our faculty members and those who are supporting from Dr. Srinivasan, sports physiotherapist, and Dr. Manoj, physiotherapist, and Uma, technical assistants, for their wonderful support to conduct the webinar as great successful one. So on behalf of the university, I extend my sincere thanks to one and all participated in the webinar. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Oh, I missed the Sagin, madam.
Excellent session.
I missed the Sagin, madam.
No, sir. It's our university function.
Thank you. So, okay.